It is officially the offseason, and the Jets are ready to reshape this roster for next season. Who the Jets sign? Find out next.
Everything changes.
What's going on, guys? My name is Yankee, and welcome back to another episode of our Jets franchise series. We are now into the offseason, and we are about to enter free agency and the NFL draft. So last episode, I asked you guys what we should do in the draft. A lot of you guys were saying, do not re-sign Ryan Fitzpatrick and go after a quarterback. So that's going to be something that I'm going to try and focus on in today's video. But what we are starting off with today, the Jets are going to franchise tag Mohammed Wilkerson. So he will be back for about $13 million next season. But after that, I kind of made a little bit of a mistake. I actually ended up skipping to the next week and I could not go back after that. So every single free agent for the Jets now became available to any other team, which was a kind of a big mistake in my part, but it was all right. We were able to regroup from that. So anyway, some of the other big decisions that we made with this Jets team, some of you guys might like these decisions, some of you guys might not, is the biggest one, the Jets are going to let Chris Ivory walk. So he was probably one of our biggest threats on offense last season. He was just asking for a little too much. He wanted too much money. And again, the Jets don't have that much salary cap, especially after franchise tagging Mohammed Wilkerson. So another big decision that we decided to do, we let Ryan Fitzpatrick walk as well. So as of right now, the only other quarterback we have on our roster, number one is Geno Smith, the other one is Bryce Petty, but he's not going to be available anytime soon to start for us. So that's another thing we're going to need. We're going to need a quarterback. And also another big player that we let walk away was Snacks. That's Damon Harrison as well. So unfortunately, guys, salary cap problems. We were not able to keep every single person on the team that we wanted to. So a lot of people had to walk as well. So now as we move on to the NFL draft, the Jets had a pretty decent draft. It wasn't as great as I was hoping to, but really this first round and the second round draft picks are really the only ones that are going to have a key role for the team in the upcoming season. So anyway, our first round pick was running back Rashawn Swanson. He's going to end up being our starting running back now for the 2016 season. He's a ranked 79 overall, and he's not too bad of a player as well. I think he's going to be definitely going to be a big part of our offense in our running game. He's pretty fast as well. He's 86 overall in the speed department. That's something I really wanted to focus on as well. I wanted to get the team younger and I wanted to get them faster as well. And that's definitely one thing that Rashawn Swanson is going to be able to do for this team. I'm pretty excited about that. I'm looking forward to that. It was a little disappointing having to let Chris Ivory go, but number one, he's not as fast as Swanson is. And number two, we could not afford him either way. So that's going to be a pretty big pickup right there, Rashawn Swanson. And then in our second round, we're going to go out and pick wide receiver Justin Jordan. He is going to be probably like our third or fourth wide receiver on the team. But the biggest thing, the reason why I wanted to draft him when I was scouting him, he's one of the fastest guys in that NFL draft. He's ranked at, I believe it's a 94 overall in speed. So he's going to be our new kick returner and punt returner. We had Jeremy Curley last season, but he was not very fast. He wasn't really a good return man. So it's going to be really cool having Justin Jordan as our return guy. We also, I believe it was in the seventh round, we drafted another wide receiver as well. He's decent. I believe his last name is Brandon, something like that. He's pretty fast as well. I believe he has like a 96 speed, so he's a little faster, but he's really not going to do anything else for us besides kick returns if Jordan was to get hurt. So those are going to be basically our draft picks. Only the top two were the only good ones. Our third round pick was like a 60 overall cornerback, something like that. And then we got a couple of middle linebacker or something like that as well. They're decent, but they're not going to probably play too much in the regular season. So now we move on to the last of the free agent signings that we have made. We do sign a couple of safeties to this team as well. That's one need that we really needed on this team. We go out and we sign Reggie Nelson, and then we also are going to go out and sign James Ahedebo as well. He was on the Jets a couple of years ago. He's coming back to the Jets this season. We just needed some depth, some backup help to help out Calvin Pryor and also help out Marcus Gilchrist as well. So those are going to be two of the safeties that we're going to sign. And the last of the free agents that we're going to sign, we're going to go out and sign a left outside linebacker, Courtney Upshaw. We needed some kind of help on those edge rushers, something like that. We definitely need that. He's definitely going to help out the team as well. And the last free agent signing is going to be a defensive tackle to replace Damon Harrison. He's going to be a 90 overall, and it's going to be Michael Brockers. Really looking forward to that, to add that to a stacked defensive line already. I do believe this defense has improved. I do believe this whole offense has improved as well. But the only other question that you guys might have is, what are we going to do with the quarterback situation. So guys, that's the question that I'm gonna have for you guys to let me know in the comments down below, because guys, I don't know what I'm going to do. What I was really trying to do is go out and try and trade for a guy like a Colin Kaepernick, have a speedy running back that if he's under pressure, he can scramble outside the pocket and pick up the first down with his legs. Unfortunately, we did let Ryan Fitzpatrick walk. He went to sign with the Denver Broncos after Peyton Manning retired. But I don't know what to do at this quarterback position, guys. One thing we did trade for a quarterback in the draft. We traded our 5th round pick to the Cincinnati Bengals for AJ McCarron. So he's going to be our backup quarterback as of right now. But our QB situation is a mess. We have starting quarterback Geno Smith as of right now. As we enter week 1 of the preseason, our backup is going to be AJ McCarron. And then our third string is going to be Bryce Petty. So, I mean, we have a decent team, but we do have a quarterback controversy as of right now. I'm not sure what to do. We do have a couple options, though. So we could go out. I was trying to trade like a first and second round draft pick to the 49ers for Colin Kaepernick. They were not biting on that. So it's going to be pretty difficult to try and trade for a quarterback, but there are a couple of free agents available. We have two people that I was thinking about. Number one is Sam Bradford. He played for the Eagles last season. You guys all know about him. He does have a history to injuries. That's the only question mark with him. And there also is another free agent quarterback, and that is Kirk Cousins. So Matt, I don't even know how he's even possibly a free agent. I'm surprised that the Redskins did not re-sign him, but he's still available as we enter week one of the preseason. So I don't know, maybe I will sign one of them, but they're only like a 75 overall. Geno Smith is a 77 overall. So either way, he would still possibly be the starting quarterback. So I'm not sure what to do about that. You guys let me know in the comments down below, though. What are we going to do at this quarterback situation? I think everything else is pretty much settled except for the quarterback situation. So I'm not too sure what to do about that. Let me know about what you guys think I should do in the comments down below. And that's how we will decide our fate for the 2016 season. That is the only other question that I have left for you guys, is to let us know what we should do at the quarterback situation. Should we stick with Geno Smith, or do we sign a guy like Kirk Cousins or Sam Bradford? Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you guys drop a like. I'll catch you guys next time. Have a good day, guys. Peace.